with yet another amazing recipe. I am so excited yet another day because today at the Young's house, Gina Young is going to share with you all how easy it is to make delicious fried green tomatoes. These fried green tomatoes right here are outrageous. They're so easy to make, doesn't require a lot of ingredients, and if you make it Gina Young style, it's gonna be so tasty. Y'all never had my fried green tomatoes before. Better make you some. Here are the lovely ingredients you will need. The first ingredient you will need would be our star, the green tomato. Now, when your green tomato starts to change colors and you know, it would change to yellow, then it would go to orange, and of course it would go to red. That's when you wanna kind of back up, because as they change colors, they do start to get softer, okay? But you can use a green tomato that does have a little bit of color on it, but you wanna make sure that it's nice and feels nice and hard, okay? So now you're gonna need some yellow cornmeal. You can use white cornmeal as well. And we are gonna be using some breadcrumbs. So here's the breadcrumbs that we will be using. And then we're gonna be using some milk. So I have just some vitamin D whole milk here. And then I have some all-purpose flour. Even self-rising flour would do the trick, okay? You will need some eggs. And we're gonna use some salt and pepper that I don't have out yet. But then if we make our way over this way, I wanna show you a really quick sauce that we're gonna put together that I love to dip my fried green tomatoes in. We're just gonna take some ranch, and we're gonna take some tomato ketchup, mix the two together, and you got a great dipping sauce. Now in this pan here, if you take a look over in this pan, I do have a little bit of vegetable oil. It's not too much, but I would say it's about this much for the pan. Make sure your hands are impeccably clean. Let's get started with this really quick and simple, yet so tasty recipe. I am so excited to share with you all how easy it is to make a delicious fried green tomato. Not everybody knows how to make a fried green tomato. And in this video today, I'm gonna show you how easy it is to make delicious ones. Now, make sure you wash off your tomatoes. You wanna wash off those pesticides, and you never know who's handled your veggies before you brought them home. So my tomatoes have already been washed off. Let's go ahead and cut them. Right about a half inch thick, I would say. Now, listen, it's very important that you don't cut them too thin, because I have found out during trial and error, if you cut them too thin, they'll become very mushy and limp, and that's not what we're looking for. So let me pick these two up so I can give you an idea what you're looking for. See that right there? That's perfect. And then you don't want to cut them too thick. Cutting them too thick, they'll never get done. The crust will be done before the tomato is done. So right there, that's perfect size. I'm so pleased with the way these tomatoes look today. All right, so we're just gonna go ahead. I remember back in the days when I was younger, fried green tomatoes were made just by using cornmeal only. So now I've found out that using cornmeal and flour mixture, or cornmeal and breadcrumbs, makes for the most perfect crispy fried green tomatoes that you're ever looking for. Okay, I'm gonna continue to cut a couple more, just like so. And when we season up our green tomatoes, we're gonna season them right there on that cookie sheet. And when you put the salt on them, salt will allow them to release a little bit of water, which is exactly what we're looking for, because we don't want these to be too watery and they mess up your beautiful crispiness to your crust that you're supposed to have. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna season them on here. That little bit of water will come out of the tomato because the salt makes some type of reaction that draws out the water, and then we'll take a paper towel and blot them. You'll get to see me do it during this video, okay? So I'm gonna continue to cut up my tomatoes just like so, and I'll be right back. So now's the perfect time. After you get your tomatoes nice and sliced up, set them onto a cookie sheet, let's get them seasoned. And you know what, if you wanted to put a tiny bit of onion or garlic powder on there, I feel like it would be delicious. I haven't done it. I usually use salt and pepper, but I just feel like it would be delicious. Okay, so let's go ahead and season up. I'm using sea salt. Like I said, keep in mind that the salt will draw some water out, which is great, but it's also going to give you some flavor, you know. All right, so we're getting our salt on, just like so, in this manner. And then we're going to put some black pepper on. You can put white pepper on. We're only going to season one side. Only one side is needed, okay? If your loved ones want more seasoning, they can put more seasoning on themselves. Okay, so now that we have that done, we're going to just set this aside for about 10 minutes to give that water some time to come out of the tomato. And once that happens, you're just going to take a nice clean paper towel and blot them, making sure that you don't blot off your spices, okay? So we're going to set these aside. And now what I want to do is I want to start to make up our dredging station. The dredging station is so easy. So anytime you're making something, you want to start off with the flour. This is all-purpose flour. We're going to be first dipping our green tomatoes into something dry, which is your flour. After we do that, we're going to need to dip it into something wet. And our wet is going to be I got tomatoes on the brain today. Two large eggs, beautiful fresh eggs we have there. And then we're going to go in with some milk, okay? Just like so, we're gonna mix the two together until those eggs are well incorporated into your milk. Now, a lot of people, let's talk about it really quickly. A lot of people like to use a buttermilk. I have used buttermilk, but most of the time I just have regular milk in the house. This will do as well. Now, the buttermilk gives you a little tang that kind of gets you right here. You know what kind of tang I'm speaking of. But the whole milk is just fine as well. Okay, so now that we have the two mixed up, when I come back, we're gonna get started dredging up some tomatoes. I'm gonna show you how easy it's done. So now I wanna mix together our breadcrumbs. And honestly, you can use any kind of breadcrumbs you wanna use, okay? This is just the kind that I like to use. It's an Italian seasoned breadcrumb, but a panko breadcrumb would make like a really crispy outside. You know, if you make your own breadcrumbs, you can use that, okay? So let's mix together equal parts breadcrumbs, all right, with equal parts cornmeal, all right? And then we're gonna go in, we're gonna mix these two together until everything is well combined. I tell you what, my mouth is salivating and we haven't even got started yet. I'm so excited. Now listen, take a look, come over this way. Take a look at the tomatoes and you can see how they're glistening because they're wet. That's what I spoke of when I said the tomatoes will release some liquid and that's what we're looking for. Now's the perfect time to go ahead, take a paper towel and kind of blot that liquid. Just like so, pretty simple, right? I'm gonna continue to mix together our mixture here. And when I come back, we're gonna get this oil nice and hot. We're frying up green tomatoes at the Young's house. So what we're doing right now is we're getting our oil nice and hot. I am using a vegetable oil. You can use peanut oil, whatever type of oil you'd like to use. Okay, so now let's take our beautiful seasoned tomatoes, okay? And we're gonna put them right into the flour. Okay, just a nice dredge right there. All right, but get it well coated and then give it a nice shake. Nice shake off, okay? And then into the milk and the egg mixture, making sure that it is nice and coated and let that extra drain off. And then guess what? Right into the beautiful cornmeal and breadcrumb batter. And you wanna coat it. You don't have to press it down if you don't want to, but you can if you want to. Okay, just get it nice and coated. After it's coated, we're gonna set it aside. Beautiful, right? Like that's perfect size, perfectly seasoned. We blotted it dry with a paper towel after the water has came out, and then we're dredging once again with the flour. This is simple. This is something you can do. It's not a hard recipe and it's gonna be delicious. Your whole family's gonna love this recipe. And guess what about these? You can eat them later on during the day after you make them. You know, some things you cook it and then you say, I don't want any because it's not freshly cooked. These taste delicious later on. Just throw them in the microwave to heat them back up. Nice and dredged just like so. I'm going to dredge the others off camera and I'll be right back to show you all what we're gonna do next. Now that we have some nice hot oil, let's go ahead and put our tomatoes right into the oil. And listen here, I feel like I feel like my oil can be a little bit hotter. So let's let that oil get a little bit hotter, because what we should see in here, right away you should hear that sizzle. You should see that sizzle all around the tomato. And since we didn't see that, we're gonna let it get a little bit hot. Because one of the worst things that you could do is fry something in oil that's not hot enough, because what'll happen to it is it'll be really oily. So that one there, I'm gonna go ahead and take it out and get rid of it. So we're here at another frying pan, and you see that sizzle. I love that sizzle. You must hear it, you must see it. But don't overcrowd the pan, because you don't want them to steam. You want for each one to lay flat. You don't want them on top of each other, you know. That way they have a chance to get nice, beautiful, and golden brown. So now we're gonna make our way to the other pan and get those fried up. My oil should be nice and hot. It is a little bit. We're gonna wait another second. Hey, listen, we're cooking live. Things are gonna happen. So now we're starting to see some golden brown towards the edge. That's your indication. Go ahead and give it a flip over. Look at that right there. That's what you want your fried green tomatoes to look like. Beautiful, crispy, and golden brown. You know, and some people may say, well, how am I gonna know when it's done, Gina? Well, you're gonna know, because you're gonna see that perfect golden brown color. You all know what fried foods are supposed to look like. When you receive that color, that's when it's done. This stubborn pan of oil right here is finally ready. We can put our other tomatoes in, get them nice, beautiful, and golden brown. Don't rush them. Don't go in bothering them with a spatula or a fork, because guess what? You will notice when, like, if you look at them like this from the side, you're gonna see that beautiful golden brown ring. That's your indication. Like I said, I know I just said it, but I wanna repeat myself. That's your indication to give it a flip over, because it is golden brown. You don't have to keep going and messing with it. Because if you do, there's a potential that you could knock off all of that gorgeous breading that we worked so hard to achieve, okay? So what I've done is I have transferred these ones that were in the pan that wouldn't heat up. I've transferred them to this larger stove because that burner was acting up. So now we got some gorgeous colors here, and I want you all to take a look at the ones that are done. Beautiful color, look how crispy, and ooh and ah. Oh, so gorgeous. I couldn't be more excited to share this recipe with you all. So what I want to do really quickly while we're waiting on the oil to drain from the green tomatoes. Don't feed anybody green tomatoes and they're oily, okay? So now we're draining them on a cooling rack, okay? I'm mixing together just ranch and ketchup. Sometimes you'll see me do ranch, ketchup, and sriracha, or sriracha ranch, you know, and a little bit of honey. Like, have fun. Make your own dipping sauce. Give it a taste and see if you're happy with it. I'm gonna taste it. So good. Let's take a look at them. Listen here, everybody. Excuse me. Sorry about that, everyone. Take a look at this. If you all enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe. Tell your family and friends and everyone you know, tell the whole world about Gina Young, what I'm doing in this kitchen on a daily basis. When I come back, I'm gonna say an amazing prayer. You all get that first bite. Take a look at it, everybody. Fried green tomatoes, Gina Young style. Make you some. Heavenly Father, we wanna thank you once again for a beautiful meal. Lord, we thank you for your love time, your mercy, and your understanding. Please forgive us for our sins. Come into our hearts and make you our Lord and Savior. Send your angels down to surround us day and night. Your Holy Spirit to help us make good decisions. Give us peace over our minds in the name of Jesus. We pray that no weapons formed against us shall prosper. And we bind the devil away from us in Jesus' name. Devil, you have no authority over this household. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the roof over our head, the food, the love, the peace and the joy you bring us every day. Amen. Amen once again to my beautiful prayer. I tell you what, I got a little choked up when I tasted my sauce. Okay, I felt like it went down the wrong pipe. Got me a little choked up. Look at this. This is beauty. Oh, look at the inside. Oh,
I can just remember eating fried tomatoes as a kid. I like the souriness. I like the freshness. I like the crispiness. I like the salt and pepper, and yum, look at that. Oh, I'm going in.
That's it.
Take a bite. Let me know what y'all think. And as always, God bless you all. Thank y'all for watching. Good night.